Hi everyone, so in this video we will be talking about rectangular hyperbola. The question goes something like this. So we have to draw a rectangular hyperbola when asymptotes are the lines which meet hyperbola at infinity. Okay? So there are two asymptotes, there will be generally two asymptotes, and here he is telling that the asymptotes are at right angles and the asymptotes are passing through a point, I mean that the curve is passing through a point that is 30 mm from one asymptote and 50 mm from another asymptote. So we have to first draw two asymptotes. So in this diagram you can see this line and this line, they are the asymptotes. And if you see the curve closely, the curve, if you extend, go on extending the curve and go on extending the lines, they will never meet. They will meet only at infinity. That is the theoretical stuff. Fine. So we will not be concentrating on the theoretical stuff. We just have to create a part of that hyperbola within our paper. And okay, so to proceed it, first we'll have to create two lines. So the two lines have to be at 90 degrees. So just make sure you have kept the polar option on, or the ortho option also you can use. So just make sure you get two lines, one vertical, the other horizontal. Then we need to take the point P through which our hyperbola is passing. So take offset of 30 mm from the bottom line and 50 mm from the left side line. So I'm using command of offset, O enter, and I'm creating this. Next up, I will create additional set of lines on this. So you see this line is total, whereas here I have created another line on top of it. So these lines I have created so that I can divide them into fixed number of parts. Fine. So either I can go on to divide them into fixed number of parts, or I can use points at required distance. Fine. So both methods are okay. So I'll just go for divide, DIV. I'll click on the line, and here, because I'll get more number of points here, so I'll choose 5 number of points. Fine. And when it comes to this line, I will choose some different number of points because the distance is less. Or instead of dividing into equal number of points, you can always go for keeping the points at constant distance. So for example, I'll take offset of 10 mm. Fine. So I'll just go on getting offsets of 10 mm this side and 10 mm on this side also. Fine. So these lines we don't need below this, so I'll just trim them off here like this. Fine. So these are the lines, right? The next what we have to do is we have to join these points. All these points will have to join here to this point. Fine. All these points have to join here. Fine. Same goes here. Okay. And then these lines I have to extend up to point where they are meeting this line. Okay. So I'll just select both the lines, then tap EX enter, and I'll go on clicking all these points. So directly these lines will get extended up to the line, up to the other line. Okay. Now these intersection points, from these intersection points I have to take line command, from this up to the first line, then from this up to the second line. Okay, I'll just zoom in to make it clear. From this point over to the second line, then from this line over to the third, and yeah, so that's all we have. Fine. So like this we'll have to take the points, and then we may have to trim the extra part off. So select this, trim this part, trim this part. Okay, so the last point we don't need it. Fine. So we have got 3 points over here, and the fourth point is this intersection point itself, and similarly we'll have to find the other points. So take line command again, starting at this point up to here, starting this point up to the second line. Again you can trim this off, TR enter, select the line, TR enter, and then click the extension. That will remove the extension. So now we have got 1, 2, 3, 4th is intersection, 5 and 6 points. Fine. So all these points you can name as it has been shown here in this diagram. Okay, so P1, P2, P3, P4 and so on. So here also you can name these points as 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay, so okay, there is a small mistake I made here. Fine. So I made mistake, fine. So this line here is actually supposed to be from this, and this here is actually supposed to be from here. Fine. So this is not there, this is not there, and we get one more line, the line which we deleted, that should have been present here. Fine. So this is the fine. So now we have all the points. Fine. Now the all the points are correct. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth and seventh. So all these points we need to join them with a spline. Fine. The spline, use the spline command to join them all properly. And once you have chosen all the points, you can just press enter to stop the command. So first line, I think it has gone out. After drawing also, you can just modify it if there is an error. And this is how we get a rectangular hyperbola. Fine. So thank you for watching our video. Hope you will practice this diagram at home and be perfect with this. If you have any doubts, you can comment in the comment section below. Hit a like to our video if you like it, and keep subscribed to our channel to remain updated about all future videos. Thank you.